The poor man's function generator. In its final stage, I want to show the final schematics. I only have 15 minutes because then my camera stops anyway. The frequency knob, fine tuning, coarse tuning, the 5 frequency bands, and here all kinds of settings to influence the waveform. Working point is the most important thing. Then the amplification of the amplifier that is connected to the output of the square wave generator. The value of the coupling capacitor to the amplifier can be changed. That also has an effect on the waveform, especially on the higher and the lower waveforms, or lower and higher frequencies, that's what I mean. You can take out the signal directly out of the generator, the square wave generator, but also via a field effect transistor. And here I made a separate panel with fixed value outputs, and the whole thing looks as it is now on top here. I've made the sine wave generator that I had built in the past. It's a 555 chip triple filter, very easy to make, and it only works on 50 Hz. I can set the frequency here with that potentiometer, and I made a separate output because I had a problem to get this generator output low impedance, so I made a separate amplifier here. Here under the silicon kit is the indicator that indicates the green LED that indicates that the circuit works. Very important, of course, because this type of generator sometimes doesn't want to start, and I have told more about that in earlier videos. The wall transformer, power supply made with a voltage doubler. I want to show the schematics when I have time. I only have 50 minutes. So let's first do the schematics. The heart of the circuit, the oscillator. Oscillator output goes to a field effect transistor. After that you can switch between the output of the field effect transistor, the source, and the direct output of the generator. And here are all these separate outputs on this part, on this panel. And here are all the different waveforms. Here are the outputs for the different waveforms, also a BNC connector, etc. I try to make the circuit in such a way that I could influence the frequency, the waveform, as much as possible, and that's why I made here a backcoupling. I have made here a kind of fool's output, and out of the fool's output we send the signal back here to the input of the one of the transistors of the generator, and that case gives peculiar waveforms, and that's why I called it a full switch. But it's also necessary for normal applications because it gives backcoupling, and that is sometimes very handy. It lifts up some waveforms, it makes them more sharp, etc., etc. There's a whole theory about it, but it's too much to explain. So here that full switch, and here the circuit. Again, here the high frequency indicator, high impedance, high frequency indicator. That's here, covered with glue. Here again, kind of block diagram of the whole circuit. For people interested in the sine wave generator, this is the circuit. I have already published it on YouTube, but this is in fact an adapted circuit because of the fact that it now has a good low impedance output. Pan over very quickly. With a 555 it's very easy to make a good sine wave generator. Here you see a three-pole filter, very easy to make. 1K resistor or 22K, three times the same capacitor, and when you study it with the scope you will see that the waveform changes out of a square wave into a good sine wave. This is an amplifier, the amplifier stage. For the audio band it's very easy to make a good sine wave. Only three capacitors are needed, one of 220 nanofarad, one of 100 nanofarad, one of 10 nanofarad, and one of 5 nanofarad. And with these values you can cover the whole band, audio band I mean. Of course this is what I've made now is not an audio generator, it's a high frequency generator. And this is the power supply, classic power supply, made with a voltage doubler, 15 volts, open voltage, AC, the voltage doubler, then the classical series regulator with two transistors and the pin connections. I want to demonstrate the at first the fool's switch. That's perhaps interesting. So now connected the scope and the counter to the fool switch. The fool's output. And when I press the fool switch, we see a very dramatic change in the waveform. And of course, you can say that's a nonsense waveform, but it can work. Let's go to higher frequencies to see the effect. And on the highest frequency that we have here, we see the ringing of the circuit. That's very interesting. You can change it somewhat by changing the coupling capacitor, by changing the field effect transistor, or take the other output. So that was the fool's out. Now we go to all the normal outputs. They are here. I always do that with crocodile clips. That works good. Here are all the normal outputs. And we see with the full switch on, even an effect here. Strange effect, but I like it. And okay, let's switch the full switch off. Now we have one of the waveforms that a circuit can make on 456 kilohertz. And change the amplification of the preamplifier. That has of course a substantial effect. And you can also see that the waveform changes, and when we change the working point somewhat, we can even get on this frequency 456 a more or less a sine wave. That must be good. Let's go to one band lower. You see, of course, that the sine wave changes. Has all to do with the properties. I do the knobs now more or less in a random way, because the time that I want to have to make this video short. Okay, let's go to the lowest frequency bands. 24 kilohertz. I think a useful waveform. Let's change the amplification of the amplifier in this circuit. Let's change the coupling from the generator to the preamplifier, and we take out the signal now directly out of the generator. Now we do that via the field effect transistor. Generator, not so much difference. Anyway, it changes somewhat. Go to a higher frequency band. Sorry, I have to change my scope somewhat. Here. And to the highest frequency band. Via the directly out of the signal generator and now coupled in via the field effect transistor. Change the amplification of the preamplifier in the circuit, and let's go to the highest frequency again, and now the thing is working via the field effect transistor stage. We take the signal out of the source and send it in. Change the working point. That of course has a substantial effect. It pinches the transistor more or less off, and you can see that. And let's go with this setting to the lowest frequency. Sorry, I have to give it more in. So kind of peaks, strange peaks. Anyway, one of the possibilities on 48 kilohertz. And when we go to the higher bands, 169 kilohertz, and take another coupling capacitor. Okay, well, that was more or less all to tell. I hope it was a kind of good demonstration. Of course, this is not a professional circuit. It's a pure hobby circuit, made for fun. But of course, it can give quite good waveforms. It can help you out in certain situations. I think you can use it to align the band filter for 455 kilohertz, on and especially in the frequency band between, say, 22 kilohertz and 400 kilohertz or 600 kilohertz. It can help you, and you can create a triangle wave and a sawtooth wave with this separate panel, and you can also get them out here, a sawtooth and a triangle wave. So it's a kind of survey of the circuit. Anyway, it took some time to make it. Of course, that's always an issue. Take your time. All the triplex plates are covered on the backside with tin plate. That was in an earlier video. Here again, that 50 hertz generator. That works very good, the power supply, etc. So thanks for watching.